Well, here we are again. Welcome to unit number two in our Training for Interpreter Trainers course. Moving along, we start our interpretive training preparation. And preparation is really key in developing interpretive training courses. The first thing I ask from our clients, and the first thing that you, if you were a client of mine, would need to develop are the objectives that you want the training to accomplish, whether they be for docents or volunteers or seasonal interpretive staff or training for professional staff, because I found that a lot of professional staff have no training in interpretation either. They kind of just do their best to communicate with the public. So I try to have you write the learning, behavioral, and emotional objectives that you want this training experience to accomplish. Now, as you write the objectives, what we look at is, can we get them actually accomplished in the time that you have allotted for the training, and the number of people who will be involved in the training? So, for example, if you want to have an objective where all of the members will have a chance to lead a portion of an interpretive tour, like in a museum, and you have 50 docents or volunteers attending, well, that experience alone could take half a day. So you need to have a course that's more than half a day long. So we look at what it is you want training to accomplish within the time frame that you have available, the number of people who will be participating, and even the knowledge level or experience of the people participating. Because all those factors have to be part of the training plan as we develop the practicum activities. Remember, people remember 90% of what they do, so the hands-on practicum, having people actually stand up and give an interpretive vignette, having them do a design for an interpretive exhibit or an interpretive panel, having them plan the introduction body and summary of an interpretive walk or talk, all those things take time. Time for them, one, to sit down and do it, and secondly, the time for everybody in the class to have a chance to do that experience. So your main assignment is to tell me what the objectives are that you would like your interpretive training to accomplish, and some of those variables, how many people would be at the training, what their level of knowledge is, and how long you anticipate the training to take place. And then I can give you some advice on if you can or can't get all that stuff done within the time frame that you have. So that's what this unit is about. It's kind of a reality check of what you want interpretation and your training course to accomplish, and can you get it done with the time and the resources and all the managerial realities that you have. And by the way, too, I've also sent you a copy of my textbook on interpretive planning, and there are chapters in there on basic interpretive principles and techniques that are a good resource for you as well. If you have any questions at all, I'm here for you. Send me an email. You can Skype me, and we can chat about this. So that's what Unit 2 is all about. What is it that you want to accomplish, and can you do it in the time allotted? And I look forward to seeing what you're going to send me. Bye-bye.